this video on differences in differences estimators and analysis of STAR project data, student teacher achievement ratio data. Here in video number 36, I have explained some basic definitions of experiments, quasi-experiments, and why we need these experiments in social sciences. Here I am going to emphasize on differences in differences estimators, and how do we estimate such models. So you see, we have, if you have simple regression is differences estimators, differences in differences estimators, y after minus y before, estimation method are the same as OLS and instrumental variable regression. So what are differences in differences estimators? You see, if we take one group as treatment group and we observe, we study it at two time periods, that is at time period 1 and time period 2, basically what happens, that it may be the case that treatment and control group differ otherwise. So the difference between just treatment before, treatment after difference will not reflect the true measure. So what we have to do, we have to basically consider that difference between control and treatment which was existing before even doing this randomization or before applying treatment. So you have treatment before, you have control group before. So they are different from each other even at the beginning level. So this is treatment before, this is treatment after, this is control before, this is control after. So you see this 40 to 80, this moves from 40 to 80, and control group moves from 20 to 30. So it means 10 units improvement is automatic even if there is no treatment. So therefore we need to take this difference into consideration while calculating actual effect of treatment. So why treatment, average treatment effect on 20, 30, whatever your sample size, minus their average before treatment, control after minus control before. So this difference is 40 here in this graph. This difference is 10. So 40 minus 10 will be impact, not 40. So 30 will be actual impact of treatment. It's not 40, as the difference between this one and this one is 40, which is not the right way. So this is called differences in differences estimators. Let's see another example from econometric analysis by Green. Many students take a SAT test, a SAT preparation course when they appear second time. So so prep, whether a prep course has an impact on SAT score improvement or not, that what we need to study. So there are two time periods, t is equal to 1, t equal to 0, t equal to 2. So if t is 1, we say it is 0. If t is equal to 2, we say it is equal to 1. Whether you have taken preparation course or not, so d is equal to 1 if you have taken prep course, and d is equal to 0 if you don't have taken prep course. So this D3, basically effect of delta, that is basically the difference between treatment after minus treatment before, control after minus control before. Those who have got this point, they can skip my next slide, which I'm going to explain for those who have slight understanding in getting this estimator, and others can skip and move next. Okay. So you see, we have YIT, beta naught, beta 2, TT, beta 3, D, and its interaction plus epsilon. T is equal to 1 if time period 2, 0 otherwise if time period 1. D is if you have taken preparatory course, if you don't have taken prep course. So you see here, YI naught means you haven't taken prep course and you are at time period 1, so it will be only beta 1 because both are 0. If you have taken time period 1, so it is 0, the first time you are appearing in SAT score, and you have taken prep course, it will be beta naught plus beta 1. So this is YI 0 for D equal to 1. Similarly, if you, it's time period 2 and you have taken prep course, you have not taken prep course, YI 1, so it will be beta 1 plus beta 2, beta 3. And if you are in time period 2 and you have taken prep course, yi1 will be equal to beta 1 plus beta 2 plus beta 3, and since d and t both are equal to 1, so delta. So basically difference between treatment and difference not treatment for those who took second time, difference between treatment and for those who did not take test first time. So therefore, no difference between this one and this one. So y bar, y bar, y bar, y bar, that is what has been shown in the previous slide. So differences in differences estimators, but there may be some other factors. What are those other factors? Students who basically assume that they can improve their SAT score by having prep course, they are more motivated, they are more willing, they are more dedicated. So it may be their motivation. So similarly, there is regression to mean effect terminology used, which we may discuss at some other time, a regression fallacy as well. So that may lead to improve or not to improve test SAT scores. So it means this D is not randomly assigned. This D is not randomly assigned. So there can be many other factors which must be taken into account. Parents' guidance or their status and all those things. So therefore, we may need to include some other variables. Those are W's, which we always use to include when your X is correlated with U, as we have discussed in detail in our instrumental variable videos. So this is what is differences in differences estimators. Okay, this increase your efficiency, check, you need to check for randomization if X is randomly assigned. As in SAT score, this taking a prep course before test is not randomly assigned. So therefore, you need to check out whether it is randomly assigned. For that, you may regress X on W's and do a F test. Adjust for conditional randomization. So you see when there is partial compliance, there are many cases when you, as we have mentioned, threats to internal validity of our experiments, that there are sometimes, there is partial compliance. That is, you basically take training, but you take training half-heartedly. So out of 50, 25 did not take training seriously. So there is partial compliance, so training impact on their productivity will not be truly measured. In that case, X and U are correlated, and then you need to work the same way as we need to. We used to work in 2SLS in our video number 29 to video number 35. Okay, that's our next video. I am basically trying to avoid it making a long one. So therefore, my next one is star data, Tennessee's class size experiment, and I am going to make next video on how to analyze this star data using regression analysis, and going to discuss these tables. Thank you for watching. Take care.